Boom, folks. Hey, it's time to talk about Vibe. You guys said you had some questions. We've got some answers. But first, we've got to take a little break and have a little, a little fun first.
Yeah. Such a vibrant thing, a vibrant thing. Yeah, such a vibrant thing, a vibrant thing.
Okay. All right. We're just having fun.
So T. Gray taught me that move this morning.
That's right.
How did I do?
You did great. You did fantastic. You got the moves.
Okay.
All right. All right. So let's get down to business and let's talk vibe, right? Because this is a vibrant thing. And we're just so excited that we're going to give you guys just a little bit of information. As you guys know, back in August, if you guys have watched our vision launch event recap video, there's a part in the video where Holton Bugs presses the button on his computer where he set the wire, the final wire, to acquire our very own ride share company, which is a major thing, right? Because from the beginning, we've been talking about iBoomerang being the Uber of the direct sales or network marketing community. And here we are now in the same business as Uber with a ride share company. That's a big boom right there, right? And so,
and it's a vibe.
It's a boom and it's a vibe. Get it? Boom, vibe. All right. I think we lost a couple of people.
Oh, okay.
Boom, vibe. All right. So, and then it's a boom vibe.
It's a boom vibe.
Hey, we didn't know that. All right. So anyway, so we've been working like crazy. When I say like crazy, I mean crazy get this thing up and running for our December 6th launch.
It's been exciting, though, man.
It's been exciting. It's been, absolutely.
Adrenaline's been flowing and it's been fun.
Yeah.
So it's cool.
So far, no one's gotten hurt. We've come close a couple of times, but we didn't hurt anybody. But in any event, here's where we are though. We've been working. I know you guys have been out there just in sheer anticipation, and I've seen the post. And I've seen some of you guys make posts that are okay. And I've seen some of you guys make posts. I'm like, I don't know that that's exactly the truth.
Maybe not so much.
Right. But we're going to give you guys some information, right? Because of course you've been waiting. The big launch, the big reveal is coming up, but in advance of that, we're going to give you guys just a little bit of information today, not everything, but just something so you know what is going on. And first of all, big congratulations to our VP of marketing and his team, because as is being put in the chat, the logo is on point. The logo is hot. You did the thing.
It's a team. It's always a team. So got to hand it off to the team, man.
That love logo is awesome. And I've got the privilege of just kind of, you know, hanging out with this dude. And I've seen like all the evolution of the Vibe logo. Yeah. And man, you guys really did a great job. This is an awesome logo. All right. Love the marketing team. That's right. That's what I'm talking about. All right. So the first bit of information that we want to give you is about the launch event. The launch event. That is Friday, December the 6th at 7 p.m. at the Fort Lauderdale Convention Center, all right? Now, this is an event that's open to all. There is no charge to be at this event. So for those of you who are coming down for Dream Weekend, and those of you who are coming down for the leadership event or the general training session, if you're in town, please come down. Come down there. For those of you who can get there, please come support the launch event. This is going to be a lot of fun. If you have drivers that you have been recruiting, or if you got down there and a few days early and you've been talking to drivers, you know, invite them to this event. This is going to be a big day, and we're going to let loose all the details there. Now, the Fort Lauderdale Convention Center is located at 1950 Eisenhower Boulevard. And we're going to be in the L room. Is that what that is?
No. Fort Lauderdale. Yeah.
But okay.
You just show up to that convention center and there will be plenty of information.
That's Fort Lauderdale?
Yes. Getting you to where you need to get to.
Okay. So, and then after, and after this really powerful reveal, which is going to be so exciting. I mean, we're really going to talk about why this is a special opportunity for drivers. You know, the rideshare opportunity has really transformed people's lives. As a matter of fact, it saved some people's lives.
Yes.
Right? Because we live in an age where technology is eliminating jobs at a rapid pace. You know, it's making it so that companies can do more with less people. So you have lots of folks, engineers and accountants and school teachers, et cetera, that need to either are driving to make extra money or driving because they've been displaced from their career. Or some people have decided, you know what, this is a real cool career where I don't have to have a boss and I can have ultimate freedom. I can work when I want to. And I already have a car, so let me put it to work, right? And that's really, you know, something for our century where people are able to take the things that they already have possession of and put them to work, like Airbnb. I've got a home. I've got an extra home. I've got some apartments. I can put them to work. Well, people are able to do that with their cars. And that's what makes rideshare exciting. But we're going to make a nice twist on it and expand the opportunity. And we're going to unveil that on Friday, December 6th at 7 p.m. That's our vibe. That's what we're doing. And then we're going to have a very cool reception to follow. It's going to be a fun event. When you see the videos, you're going to wish you were there. So definitely we want to encourage you guys to do there. And we're doing some cool stuff.
Yes.
That I can't talk about.
Yeah, no.
But it's going to be really cool.
Yeah.
And when you see it, you're going to be like, wow, they did it like that. And we're going to be like, yes, we did. Right. They're like, you did that. I'm like, yes, we did. Right. So that's how it's going to go. All right. So here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. All right. Where are we launching VibeRide? Now, you've heard us say we're launching in Florida. We're launching in Florida. But Florida is a really big place. Okay. Florida is a really big place. And so we're being smart about this. Because even though we have another state that we could, you know, that we could launch right now in, we're like, okay, let's do the right thing. Let's do the smart thing. We owe it to our ambassadors to do this in a controlled and disciplined way so that we don't fail and they don't fail. So we're going to start with Florida, and we are going to focus on the most congested cities in Florida. Okay, what are those? Miami, Fort Lauderdale area, Tampa, and Orlando. Miami, Fort Lauderdale, Tampa, and Orlando. Now, there's a lot more cities in Florida, and you got some small cities, and you got some spread out cities. And we just want to encourage you to focus your driver recruitment, focus your rider recruitment on these cities. And I'll tell you why. We really don't want people to have a bad experience where they're looking for a ride. They're excited because you're excited and we don't have any drivers, or we don't have enough drivers, okay? And we also don't want people to become drivers and be really excited and there's not enough riders to get, you know, for them to make an income. So we have to focus and expand. Does that make sense? Focus and expand, all right? Wherever you are watching, I want you to do this. Focus and expand. All right. It's like a yoga class. Breathe in, breathe out. Okay. Anyway, enough of that. So you guys get the idea. All right, cool. All right. So next up, here's what we've been working on. Two apps. Count them. Two. Boom. That's what I'm talking about. Give it up to Mark Kithcart. That's some really fast slide making you did there. Yes. So we're working on two apps.
Yep.
Two apps.
Yep.
We have a driver app and we have a rider app. Okay. Just like the other rideshare companies, because the drivers need to use a special app in order to do their business of driving for VibeRides, right? Driving, right? And then the riders need to use an app in order to hail a ride, you know, follow their ride, follow their driver, get to their destination, all that kind of cool stuff. And our apps are going to have lots of cool features. Not going to talk about them today, but we're building in cool features. And we will constantly, one of the things that you're going to see is in the beginning, you're going to see this app getting updated very, very frequently as we add free features. Okay. Our coders are literally writing thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands and thousands of lines of code every single day in order to create the features of the app. Can't launch with all the features at once. And so what happens, it evolves over time. For example, if you want to take the Uber app, for example, just think back, if for those of you who've been Uber customers for a number of years, think about how many new features just kind of came out versus when they first started. going to be kind of the same evolution, but a little bit faster. Okay. All right. Now, one thing that we are going to do, because we want to make sure our customers do not have a bad experience, and we're going to need to ramp this thing up super fast. And we've got some incredible plans on our end to drive adoption, right? Create awareness and drive and create adoption so that you have people wanting to drive for Vibe, people wanting to use it. But in the beginning, as we are ramping up drivers, we want to make sure that any riders that are looking for a ride don't get stranded. So what we'll do is when they request a ride, if there's not a driver, we're going to tell them, hey, listen, we're growing. And so we don't want to, you know, we don't have a driver for you right now. So here's what we want to do. We don't want to leave you stranded. We're going to pass this request over to Uber or Lyft, your choice. Press the button. And when they press, you know, they like Lyft, they press Lyft, their Lyft app on their phone will open up with the information in it already as a courtesy to them, right? If they choose Uber, same thing. Let me tell you why we're doing this. It shows love for the customer. We lose that ride, but we don't lose the customer. I'll tell you one major company that's a multi-billion dollar company that does the exact same thing. It's called Zappos. So if you go to Zappos.com and you try to find a pair of shoes and you call their customer service and they don't have that shoe in your color or your size, their customer service team is trained to open up a browser, search the internet, and find somebody else, another company, a competitor that has those shoes in your size and color, and to tell you where you can go get them, right? Because their philosophy is, hey, we want to make this customer happy. And we might not get this sale, but we're going to get that customer's heart. And that's what we're going to do. We're going to get your customer's hearts. So in the beginning, while we ramp up drivers, that's what we'll do. You don't get paid on those, of course, but your customer doesn't get angry. Your customer has a good experience. Say, okay, they don't have a driver yet. I'll come back. I'll try them again. In the meantime, I'll take my normal Uber or Lyft. All right. So hopefully you guys love that. Hopefully you guys understand that. That's a real smart move on the part of the Vibe development team. All right. Let's talk about getting paid. You guys ready to get paid? Let's talk about getting paid. All right. Every ride pays out 5, right? 5 payouts on every ride. I know you guys wanted to know something about the economics, but there will be 5 payouts on every ride. Let me show you how this is going.
So one thing that we were talking about too in the idea room the other night was this is ride share to the third power.
Oh, we're not telling them that stuff yet. We're just a secret. That's a secret, because we got some cool names for stuff. We got some cool terminology that we're saving for December 6th.
Okay.
Right. You got to be there. You got to be in it to win it. You got to be there to hear it. Okay. All right. That kind of rhymed just a little bit, but not so much. So 5 payouts on every ride. Okay. Now there's a lot of text on here, but I'm going to work it through for you guys. Okay. So the first payout on the ride is to the driver. Right. Obviously, drivers are driving to get paid, and we're going to pay the driver a percentage of the base fare. Okay. And we want to start talking like that. We want to start communicating this way. All right. Because it's important, because, you know, our philosophy at iBoomerang and at VibeRide, because VibeRide is a separate company, is in integrity and transparency. We have the it factor. Right? You guys heard that before? The iBoomerang it factor. Well, the iBoomerang it factor is also the VibeRide it factor, integrity and transparency. And where a lot of companies have gotten in trouble is that they tell the driver, you get a percentage. And they don't say a percentage of what. And so the driver is misled into thinking it's a percentage of the entire amount that the rider pays. But just think about your cell phone bill for a second, right? When you look at your cell phone bill, there's the actual part that's for service, and then you got taxes and fees and all sorts of stuff that get tacked on, and nobody gets paid on those, but the governments, et cetera, right? Well, the anatomy of our rides, it will have a base fare, right? That goes to the company, and then there's taxes and there's tolls and all that. I'm sorry, not the base fare. There's a base fare, right? And then there's the company per ride fee. Uber's got one, Lyft's got one, everybody's got one, you know, what the company charges per ride. And then you have taxes, tolls, et cetera. What the driver gets paid on is the base fare. Okay. And so we're going to pay the driver a percentage of the base fare. Okay. Now, second, we're going to, now is when we start to pay the team. This is now we start to pay the team. All right. And this is really exciting. So think about who's in the car. You got a driver and you got a rider. Okay. You got a driver and a rider. So we're going to pay a direct bonus, just like our travel savings bonus, to the person who got the driver. All right. So if that's your driver, every time they make a ride, you're going to earn a direct bonus. Okay. But you have an upline. And just like we do with travel savings, we pay them upline as well. We're going to also pay upline of the person who got the driver. All right. So that's, we'll call that a driver override or something cool over the next couple of weeks. All right. But then you got the rider. Well, we're going to pay a direct bonus to the person who got the rider. All right. So again, just like our travel savings bonus, we're going to pay a direct bonus to the person who got the rider in the car. All right. And we're going to also, that person who got the rider also has an upline. So we're going to pay an override to that person's upline as well. So that's five commissions or five payouts on every ride. You got the driver, you got the person who referred the driver, you got that person's upline, you got the person who got the rider, you got that person's upline. And so the exact percentages, oh, you want to know the percentages? See you in Florida. All right. Awesome. Awesome. He said, stop teasing us. Right. Right. Someone said, do I get paid if you're the rider? No, riders don't get paid. Oh, but I mean, if you are the rider as an ambassador, you do not get paid on the ride. Right. Unless the driver is your driver. It's possible. Right. Okay. So there you go. All right. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Next up. What about the driver opportunity? What about the driver opportunity? Here we go. There will be two ways to drive or two driver opportunities, okay? The first opportunity is to just drive only, okay? That's the pure rideshare opportunity, just like Uber drivers, just like Lyft drivers. Don't wanna do any business. I just wanna drive. And I just want to get paid for driving. No problem. If that's what you want to do, you can most certainly do that here. Okay. There's no charge. There's no sign up fee in order to be a just driver. Okay. You do have to, there's no monthly fee in order to be a just driver. Now you do have to pass the background checks in order to drive for Vibe Rides because we're all about safety. Okay, so we're gonna check your driver history with the motor vehicle organizations, and we're gonna check and see if you have a criminal history as well, okay? And here's what happens, the drivers pay for that. We're working on a potential idea of maybe how we can reimburse drivers for that after they do a certain amount of rides. That's just an idea. Do not post that as a fact that we're doing it, but we just want you to know that we're thinking of that and we're working to see if that's something that we can do. But right now, the only thing a driver has to pay for in order to drive for us is their background check and their vehicle inspection, okay? So we wanna make sure that their vehicles are safe. So they're gonna have to go and get a 19-point vehicle inspection. We're gonna tell them what those 19 points are. They'll be able to go to any place that can inspect your vehicle, like an oil change place, and get that. And then once it is certified and comes back to us, then they'll be ready to drive, okay? And we're gonna see if we can work out some cool things around the vehicle inspection too. So we're working on all sorts of cool ideas. Then we're gonna have a training for the drivers. It's gonna be video-based. And by the way, speaking of video-based, we're gonna put together a really cool presentation for drivers so that you do not have to present to drivers. This is not a very complicated thing. The presentation won't be more than really 5 or 10 minutes. And we're going to make sure it's video based. And that way your drivers, you know, when you have somebody who wants to drive, you just send them a link. They watch it. They decide to rock and roll. Great. Click the button. They're in the process. All right. And then of course, we're going to give them the decals for their cars. As you saw us put them not on cars, but on our water bottles, because we drive water bottles around here, I guess. Right. No, something like that. All right. So that's the drive only opportunity. Okay. That's a drive only opportunity. Okay. All right. Now, next is to is a more expanded opportunity, right? So, you know, so you can drive only and then you get paid on you, right? That's a linear income. You get paid when you drive, you don't get paid when you don't drive. We're going to give drivers the opportunity to have leverage, to really create their own rideshare business within our rideshare business. That's super cool. And so they can become a driver ambassador. That's not the name. We have a cool name. We're just not telling you today. I'm sorry, guys. We said we're going to give you some of the info. We can't give you all of it. We can't spill all the beans today, right? So you'll hear the name of that on, you'll hear the name of that on Friday, December 6th, when we roll out the full deal. All right. So this is the expanded opportunity to be a driver ambassador. This is an opportunity to take rideshare entrepreneurship to a whole nother level and not just earn money when you drive, but to create a residual income that happens even when you're not in a car. All right. Now, for this one, the driver will have to buy a pack and they will have to pay a monthly subscription for this opportunity. Now, this opportunity will allow them to recruit and get paid on drivers, okay? And also to acquire and get paid on riders. So you can now build your own team of drivers and get paid when they drive, not just get paid when you drive, but get paid when they drive. Also to allow you to actually get customers, and here's an opportunity that doesn't exist anywhere, get paid when the customers ride and use VibeRides. Even better, as your team of drivers goes out and recruits other drivers and gets more riders, you get to override and get paid on those rides as well, okay? Now, hold on a second. I wanna address some of the things that are happening in the chat, right? I've got some folks saying from Uber saying, hey, you know what? Uber and these guys, they pay for the background checks. Yes, exactly. Uber's a massive company and they can pay for the background checks. But here's what, by the way, let me tell you how much background checks cost before you fall out of bed over background checks. $30 in Florida. All right, we're talking about $30. We're talking about roughly $12 for the motor vehicle check and another $16 for the criminal check, okay? So we're not talking about a huge sum of money. And as we grow, as we start to understand our economics, as I mentioned before, and I saw somebody put in there, we will refund the cost. No, we are working on that. I don't wanna use committal language here, okay? Because we have the integrity and transparency factor. And so I don't want to say something that is not guaranteed at this time. We're working on it. Our heart is in a place where we would like to pay for that for people, but we need to get out of the gates first, okay? So it's not a monumental cost. It's $30. That's pretty much it. And we will, you know, as I mentioned, it's our intent to be able to get the back.
Do we have to be in a certain class, coach, business, first class to recruit drivers and passengers?
The answer to that question is no.
That's you can cool. be coach, business, or first.
If you're an IBM ranked family, yep. You can do it.
Yep. And then will there be an additional, so current ambassadors will be able to drive also?
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. You just have to follow the process. And so what I want to caution you guys, hey guys, you got to use our background check company. Okay. That's right now, that's the way it works. We can't just take from other sources. We've identified a company that we're going to work with for safety reasons and for legal reasons. We have to do it a certain way. We have to have a certain level of discipline. So you can't just go get your driver record from someplace else. No, we need a verified driver record. And the way that we can make sure is you got to use our company. All right. You got to use our company that we have partnered with to do it. We don't make any money on it. The exact amount that they charge us is what we're passing on to you guys. We're not looking at background checks and motor vehicle checks or vehicle screening or vehicle 19-point inspections, which you can get from anywhere. We're not looking at those as a profit center. Those are just a necessity to make sure that we can provide safety for the riders and the passengers. Okay. This is going to be a very special opportunity. One of the things that people complain about is that they say that there's not a lot of love for drivers or some of the other companies. We're going to show our drivers lots of love. There's so many things that we're planning to do for the future that we haven't even begun to talk about yet, because we're working on them. And we've got so many cool things that we're going to do for passengers. So listen, folks, this is an opportunity you definitely can get excited about. But we have to follow some rules and regulations, especially as we are getting going. So let's get back to this driver ambassador opportunity, though. Think about this for a second. You have the opportunity to get paid when you're behind the wheel, when you are working, right? But we're going to give you the opportunity to create a residual income. And what's going to happen, I believe it's going to happen, and I know it's going to happen in a relatively short period of time, is you're going to have drivers who begin to earn so much money from their leverage part of their business, from the override part of their business, from other drivers driving, and from passengers riding, that they will no longer drive themselves. And that's an exciting day. We want to see, I'm looking forward to seeing that type of stuff happen for people. And again, I see some detailed questions happening here. We'll make sure that we give you guys all full details. That's not the point of this training, just to give you some information, right? To give you a taste, right? It's kind of like when grandma invites you in the kitchen so that you can taste what she's making, but she doesn't really intend for you to come in here with a plate and try to make a whole plate, okay? So we're just gonna give you just a taste today. And by the way, background checks, here's a cool thing. Guess what? I learned this yesterday from a conference call that we had with our background check company. Guess how long they take?
How long?
If you've got nothing on your record, if you've got a clean driver record and you got a clean criminal history, it's pretty much instantaneous.
Awesome.
Like literally like that, right? Or maybe like 4 or 5 minutes, but right then and there. So anybody who's got a clean record is going to be able to get going very, very quickly, okay? Now, if you've been doing some stuff, you've been running some red lights, not so much. All right. Okay, cool. We're going to keep it going. So what do you do at this point in time if you want to drive for Vibe Rides? If you want to drive with us, we are capturing, this is an interest capture page. Okay, this is an interest capture page. This is not the actual sign up. We just want to know who is, who's wanting to ride with us, okay? So let me see, I thought I had this thing open in a window here, but I don't. No, it's kind of what's a stretch of my whole desktop. Okay. But if you go to drivewithviberides.com, here's what you need to do. If you have somebody who wants to drive, they need to go here, just let us know. We just wanna see who's out there, who's interested. Fill this out and plug in the TSA number of the person who referred you. Okay. Yeah. If you don't have one, no problem. But if you are referred by a person who's one of our ambassadors, they have a TSA number or an A number, plug that in with your information. We just want to know who is, who's wanting to roll with us. Okay. Vibe Rise. Okay. Hold on a second. We're getting a note.
That was awesome. I don't think it was pertaining to this.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Cool. All right. So, do I have any more slides?
No, that's it.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's your taste, everybody. That's you wanted to give you guys a taste of what we're working on for Vibe Rides. We gave you guys just a little bit of information so that you can have, you know, kind of a mindset. As we mentioned, we're focused on the most congested cities in Florida. We're bringing it in a way that's never been done. All right. I mean, the just drive part, mm-hmm. is pretty standard, right? There's not really too many different ways to do the just ride part, but that expanded opportunity is everything. Yeah. Is everything. So we're going to show folks who are interested in the ride share business how to do more than just drive, mm-hmm. but how to get a bigger vibe on, mm-hmm. and create some real wealth and some serious income for themselves.
Yeah. So one of the things that I was just blown away by this. So again, you know, everything we do here is hashtag just different. And the way we're going and approaching the ride share market is just different as well. So just to let you guys know, it is going to be different than anything else you've seen. So somebody was putting in the chat, you know, hey, Uber drivers also get paid on other Uber drivers. But do the Uber drivers get paid also on customers that are taking rideshare as well? So for instance, you know, they have a customer that they've, you know, brought, maybe had in their Uber, but next thing you know, they take another ride somewhere else with someone else, and definitely they do not get paid on that type of activity. So bottom line is this, it's going to be just different. And, you know, I saw some of the numbers too. And I said, you know what? Some of these drivers aren't going to need to drive anymore.
They're not.
And because they're going to be doing so well as a driver ambassador, you know, name to come soon. But bottom line is this, and again, everything you see and hear and understand, people can copy, right? You know, copying someone there's some companies out there right now that are
trying to copy
us. And that's flattery. That is complete flattery to us that we're, you know, heading in a direction that everybody wants to go based on how well we're doing. But here's the thing. Here's what they don't have. They don't have a Mr. Holton Bugs, a visionary. They don't have Miss Erling Bugs. They don't have our global master ambassador, Mr. Edwin Haynes. They don't have a T. Gray. They don't have the team that we have. And I say it all the time. I don't go and follow products or services or companies. I follow leadership and vision, and we have that in spades here. So bottom line is this, we're going to come out with VibeRide, and guess what? There's going to be a whole bunch of other companies that are going to pop up with VibeRide lookalikes.
Paying out 5 commissions on a ride.
Yeah, or no, then they're going to say, well, we pay out 7 commissions on a ride.
Yeah, something like that.
So anyways, bottom line is this, you know, we have something that is special that other companies don't have, and I call that vision and leadership.
And you know what? You touched on a point, and it set off a little bit of fire in the chat group. Yeah, Uber does pay if a driver recruits a driver. Yeah. But here's how it works. That driver has to be on for 90 days. They have to do a certain number of rides, and you get 1 commission, right? That's not what we're doing here. We're saying you get to recruit a driver, and that driver, every time they drive from that point forward, you get paid. You get paid over and over and over again. If they drive for the next 5 years, you get paid on every drive that they do. If they drive for the next 10 years, you get paid on every drive that they do. But here's more. When that driver decides they want to be a driver ambassador too, and they start to recruit other drivers, and let's suppose that over time, this group of drivers becomes a group of 100 drivers, you now get paid every time these 100 drivers drive, every time, not over, you know, there's no qualification period. There's no limited period of time. It doesn't stop. It keeps going. But on top of that, you can now get customers, and nobody does that. So what happens is now you can promote the VibeRide service to people who are going to download the app and use it to go on a date, or use it to go hang out with their friends, or use it to go to the airport, or use it to go to a concert, or use it to go to a club, or use it to go to work, or use it to get around another city when they're traveling. And every time they use it, you get paid. But it gets even better than that, because as your team of driver ambassadors, as they get customers, as they get riders, you get paid a little piece when all those riders ride every single time as well. If that doesn't light your fire, then your wood is wet. Yeah, you remember that? Yeah. If that doesn't light your fire, it's like a Texas thing. If that don't light your fire, then your wood is wet, right? So, folks, that is the power of the opportunity that we're bringing to the table. I want to make sure you don't miss it. And we have so many cool details that we are going to share with you in Florida. So, again, I want to put this back up here. Drive with,
no,
is that, that's not right.
No, it's not right. It's drive for.
It's drive for.
Yep. Okay. I messed that up. That's
okay.
My fault.
Okay. So
I've got it in all the chats.
Can we, it's in the
chats? Yeah, it's in the
chat. Okay. Drive for VibeRides, not drive with. Drive for. Drive for, F-O-R.
Yeah.
VibeRides.com. Again, this is an interest form. That's all it is. We just want to see who's interested, who's thinking about it, who's saying, you know what, when this rolls out, I'm in, I'm down. And remember, as you send people there, make sure that they plug in your TSA number.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, I was making that slide a little late last night, but that's okay.
That's all right, man. It's okay. It's all right. It's okay. It's okay. All right. So hopefully that was a good taste for you guys, and hopefully whets your appetite for the rest of the meal. Okay. And what else we got?
So
every so often, there's a change. A disruption. Something that has never been done before. A moment in time when everything changes. When change is needed the most. This is one of those times. What will happen when an icon in the industry enters the world's largest market with a brand new model? Records will be broken. Lives will be changed. And nothing will remain the same. If you're watching this, you could be there. At the very beginning of what will be one of the biggest shifts the industry has ever seen. Watch as we deliver on a promise and a new vision like no one has ever seen before. Whatever you do, don't miss it.